In this episode 3 of the Triple Negative series on Health Chats, we discuss about late-stage triple negative breast cancer. Watch previous episodes at Talk Health Asia's YouTube channel and don't forget to subscribe.
I opened this to both Prof Yip and Dr. Nina, right? In terms of treatment, would the modality be different, hugely different for early TNBC versus late TNBC?
Actually, I don't think so. Because TNBC needs definitely chemotherapy, surgery, and radiotherapy if lumpectomy is done or they have lymph nodes involved, you know. And we will argue about what size of tumor do we advocate neoadjuvant chemo. That means chemo before surgery. Because I once had a patient with a 8 millimeter screen detected triple negative breast cancer. I said do surgery first. She went and saw somebody else who said give chemo first. And I say for an 8 millimeter tumor, that's a bit extreme. Nina, What size do you think we should give chemo first? 2 cm is considered early breast cancer.
Yeah. So, I mean, as you said, we follow our guidelines. There's no hard and fast rule. But if we look at sort of the European Society Medical Oncology Guideline, they would say sort of anything more than 2 cm, we can advocate for neoadjuvant or pre-op chemotherapy.
Yeah, for early breast cancer, when it comes to surgery, if the lump is small enough and it's not multifocal, we can still do lumpectomy.
In the metastatic or stage 4 triple negative breast cancer, usually what that means is that the cancer has spread from your breast to other parts of your body, either via lymph node or via blood vessel to other organs. And when that happens, we are not talking about sort of aggressive curative intent. And what we are trying to do is trying to control the cancer. The treatment is, we use this word systemic. Systemic means treatment that involves immunotherapy, sort of chemotherapy, which would be tailored for the patient. If the patient has BRCA positive breast cancer, then we would be thinking about PARP inhibitor that we discussed before. What can you do for yourself? I think this is the question that a lot of our participants and a lot of patients ask. Hey, so what about me? How can I empower my cancer journey? What can I do for myself? Having a network is really important when you're going through this journey, or having that support group like breast BCWA, because I think it's a very lonely journey to go through it yourself and alone. And I feel like as a woman in this age, we feel we can do it, everything and anything. I can do it. I've had so many young breast cancer patients in their 40s who comes in alone. They've got their child at home and their husband looking after their child. And I'm like, where are they? Where's your support system? And they're like, no, it's okay. I can handle this. I can also, you know, look after my child. And I'm like, no, listen, you need the help here. It's going to be different because you're so used to look after everyone else that when the table turns, you don't know how to deal with it.
That's why this campaign is called Together Gather, and we're trying to promote the power of female friendships. Because if the husband has to look after the kids and our parents are too old, our siblings are busy, that's where friends come in, isn't it?
Subscribe to Talk Health Asia's YouTube channel for more Health Chats episodes, or find easy to understand health videos on talkhealthasia.com.